Hi everyone, and welcome to our channel. In this episode, we're going to take a look at a topic that is often referred to, but rarely really discussed. Modeling resolution as compared to screen resolution. We've all been taught that modeling resolution is important when we're doing 3D modeling. But how important is it? That's what we'll take a look at. As well as, does the screen resolution really affect the outcome of the product? So, let's get started. I have a standard job setup. It's 24 inches by 24 inches, but the key here is that I have it set for standard model resolution. I have some vectors that form a chain link, because I want to make a chain link frame 24 inches or 20 inches by 20 inches. Just a note, as always, watch your nodes. The more nodes you have, the rougher your end product will be. So minimalize them if you can. I first select my first link, and I'm going to create just a simple rounded component set to merge. You can see how jagged the edges are. Again, this is standard resolution, and I'm not surprised at the quality. Even in the 3D view, you could see how poorly the component came out. Let's take another look at it. I'm going to make a model of my visible components, so I'm only dealing with a one solid component, and I'm going to rotate it around the center 60 times. Not the highest quality looking frame, I would have to say. So let's change the modeling resolution to maximum and see what kind of effect that has. I select my two vectors again for my first link. Same component shape and height, set to merge, create the component, and make a new one for our second link. Much better quality. Again, this is set to maximum. And this is what we should expect. So the modeling resolution really does have an effect. And I'm going to make a model of the visible 3D components so that I can rotate that new component around the center to form my frame. Much better at maximum resolution. But there are other aspects that you may want to consider. Now, please know this will also slow your computer down in its calculation speed. If you change the modeling resolution back to standard, the component that was made in the maximum modeling resolution still retains its quality. Selecting that component, rotating it around the center, you could see our chain link frame looks a lot better than our previous. There is still some distortion, of course, but it's better looking overall. Here you can see the difference between the original standard modeling resolution component and the maximum model resolution. And if we choose to create a boundary vector, you could see how oddly those vectors come out. So the modeling resolution plays a big part in the entire process that you would be working through. Let's take a look at something else. The software comes preloaded with some 3D clip art. I wonder if the modeling resolution has any effect on these. I'm going to select one, the fleur-de-lis, and we're going to rotate it again like we did previously around the center 60 times to create a frame. or border. This first border, the modeling resolution, is set to standard. I'm going to change it to maximum now, choose my second fleur-de-lis, rotate that around the center, the same amount, 60 times, and let's compare. The outer frame is maximum resolution, the inner frame is standard resolution. And if we look at it closely, we'll see there's almost no difference. That's simply because the quality of these models is extremely high to begin with. Vectric has done a wonderful job at creating good quality components for us to use at any resolution. Let's try something different. We're going to have our new job set up with standard resolution. And we're going to import a 3D model that we found on the internet. You may have seen it before. It's a sailing ship. I'm going to adjust it so it will fit within my material, making sure that it's set to the center of my material and also and that the entire model is visible. Now that we've imported this 3D model, let's take a look at it. Standard resolution, remember. How does it fare? I don't know who made this, and I really don't know the quality of it from its original source. But if we look closely at it, we can see this distortion slightly shows up, especially on the top edge of the sails. It's very rugged and very pixelated. Is this how the model was originally made? I don't know. Let's try it one more time. Choose a new job setup, but this time the modeling resolution will be set to maximum. Will this have an effect on importing a 3D model? Well, here's the same model. We're going to do the same thing, adjust its size, make sure that the entire model is visible. And now let's zoom in to see if the edge of the sail is any better. And it is. So the modeling resolution when you first start really does have an effect on not only the models or components that you make, but also the ones that you may find somewhere else and import. Let's take a look now at screen resolution. Some would say that this has no effect. I'm not sure. I drew some ovals. And I'm going to choose a simple profile cut. Now there's no 3D components or pixels involved. It just should be a simple straight through profile cut. And should have nice clean edges. But we'll take a look at our preview. And it's set to standard as by default. Let's just zoom in to see what it looks like. This is where that old saying of what you see is what you get may not apply. I would have expected that a profile cut would not have the jagged edges that I see in the preview. But take a look at this. If I change the preview resolution to maximum, the software automatically deletes what you see. I can then go in and re-click on to preview the toolpath of the profile. And now it looks as I would have expected. Clean, sharp edges. So the modeling resolution deals with 3D components, but the preview resolution deals with what you see in your 3D view. So my recommendations, I would suggest the modeling resolution be set to very high and your preview simulation quality be set to very high as well. That way I think you get the best of both worlds. a good view into 3D view, as well as the speed of your computer calculation. If you want to learn more about the Vectric software, subscribe to my channel. And don't forget to click on the bell to be notified of our next video. And as always, if you need some help, send me an email, mm@mezalick.com. I'll see what I can do. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Enjoy.